discussion? Roll call. Babcock?
Aye.
Eckhart?
Aye.
Farian?
Aye.
Hahn?
Aye.
Order?
Aye.
Zeper?
Aye.
Item number 5, reading and acceptance of the minutes again for April 12th. May I have the suggested motion for that?
I make a motion to approve the minutes from the following meeting of the Board of Education, April 12, 2017, regular Board of Education meeting and executive session as presented.
Second. Discussion? Roll call. Babcock?
Aye.
Eckhart?
Aye.
Farian?
Aye.
Hahn?
Aye.
Order?
Aye.
Zeper?
Aye.
Mrs. Becker, if you will read the certification of the Board of Education election results, please. For a 2-year term, your Barbara A. Kane with 5,940 votes. 2-year term, David Border, 4,131 votes. 4-year term, Frank J. Anarino, 5,395 votes. 4-year term, Michael Smolka, 6,259 votes. 4-year term, Anthony Wong, 5,399 votes. 4-year term, James G. Eckert, 3,321 votes. 4-year term, Lisa Beth Schupak, 5,711 votes. 4-year term, Margaret Peggy Babcock, 3,797 votes. 4-year term, Gerald Z. Chapman, 4,076 votes. 4-year term, Adam Bowski, 3,697 votes. 4-year term, Asad Sid Aman, 2,943 votes.
Hey, tonight we are honoring 6 board members for their service to the children and adults of District 15. Board members give up countless hours over the course of the year in their dedication to govern the school district to the betterment of the children they serve. There is no higher calling, in my opinion. Children's futures and the societies of tomorrow are dependent upon a quality public education. These 6 members accepted this responsibility and led the district to a better place through their dedication and commitment. As citizen leaders, these school board members faced complex and demanding challenges, many not easy. They had the most important volunteer job in the country and faced some of the toughest challenges in elected American government. Yet these 6 school board members are just ordinary citizens with an extraordinary dedication to our public schools. All District 15 citizens should recognize the vital contributions of these 6 board members over the course of their terms. Their job was to establish a vision for the education program, design a structure to achieve that vision, ensure schools were accountable to the community, and strongly advocate continuous improvement in student learning. While sometimes it seemed like a thankless job devoid of any glory, the district is in a better place because of their efforts. Therefore, it was with gratitude of the thousands of children and parents, staff, and committee members that I present you with the gift that you got on your desk when we arrived. It's a golden school bell, and every time you ring it, a little kid in school gets out of detention. So.
Didn't
it be mine? Dave Durian served on the board from 2016 to 17. There was never a doubt that Dave thoughtfully reflected on each decision, ensuring the children of the community were the primary consideration. The board operated at a higher level due to Dave's involvement and his insights. Dave Siebert served on the board from 2011 to 2017, the last 2 as secretary. He was a champion of providing positive educational experience for students and district. Despite the demands of his role as a board member, he also spent time coaching and organizing youth baseball, softball, and football in the community. True community servant. Jessica Morrison served on the board for the past 2 years. An attorney by trade, she possessed insight and wisdom that benefited the work of the governing board. Her resolve to positively impact education being delivered to the students was firm. She was an impassioned member who brought much to the table, assisting her fellow board members and the administrators of the district. Jim Eckbert also served the board for the last 4 years, and most recently as the board's vice president. He also had a previous 4-year run in 2007 to 2011. Jim also served as a resident physician for his alma mater's football team, Palatine High School, where he spent numerous nights, many of which involved frigid and inclement weather, on the sidelines of football games, assisting the team with any injuries or medical issue. Jim also worked on the District 15 Wellness Committee His prescription for EpiPens has saved at least 2 lives within District 15. Jim's commitment to the position was evident in the numerous hours he invested to earn his Master School Board recognition from the Illinois Association of School Boards. His training shone clearly whenever he spoke. Though his words were infrequent, they were always words of wisdom and focused on the betterment of the children in the district. Dr. Chapman is a retired educator with more than 36 years of experience as a teacher, administrator, and superintendent in District 211, and he is partially responsible for the high quality of education of those schools today. After leaving 211, he was an associate dean of College of Education at Roosevelt University, longtime resident of the Palatine Township. Dr. Chapman's own children graduated from District 15 schools, and he previously served on the Board of Education from 2007 to 2011. He has a deep commitment to our community and is evidenced by his service on the Bridge Board, the Palatine Chamber of Commerce Board, as well as serving as a commissioner in the Palatine Rural Fire Protection District and overseeing local cemeteries. Peggy Babcock has served on the board since 2009, and she served as the board's president for the past 2 years. She led the board through some challenging times and leaves the district in a better place because of her leadership. During her time on the Board of Education, Mrs. Babcock visited all of the 20 schools annually. She walked the halls, observed the classrooms, talked with principals and staff members, and she communicated a sincere concern and appreciation for everyone she met. Mrs. Babcock has long been a servant of the community. For over 26 years, she has volunteered to assist cancer patients with their harrowing journey through radiation, chemotherapy, and the long road to recovery. She also served on the District 15 Foundation, working to enhance children's experiences in the district. Despite the challenges and difficulties the board faced while she was on the board, students remained her focus, and every action she took was to increase the success of the students she served. This year, she will be honored by the Illinois State Board of Education as a recipient of Those Who Excel Award. The departure of all these board members leaves a void. However, these individuals leave the district in a better place and ready to be taken over by the new board. There's a great deal of optimism that the new board will build upon the work that's been done by this board. So please join me in thanking these members for their service and wishing them luck in their future endeavors.
And with that, for the last time, can I have a motion to adjourn, please?
I make a motion to adjourn, sine die.
So, you know, I'd like to make a couple of comments before we adjourn. Just on a personal level, I know that for coming into the school board a couple years ago, all of the you know, Dr. Eckberg, and Peggy, and then Jerry, and everybody, and David here, they welcomed me with open arms, and there was a long kind of learning process that I think a lot of board members don't, you know, at least I didn't know when I came in that it would be as steep of a learning curve as it was. So personally, I just want to thank all of you for providing that education to me. I think that the one great thing about this experience with the board, what I can say for myself, is that I like the fact that we took bold action. You know, this district is an outstanding district. I think there was a couple of meetings ago, there was a substitute teacher, or an ex-substitute teacher or ex-teacher that was here who extolled some of the virtues of District 15. And I think that that's very important. And those values, I think, have been taught to me and are very apparent. And you know, this district is great because there's outstanding academics. We saw that the PARC tests improve every year since I've been on this board. We've had difficult problems, like we've talked about the achievement gap, and we didn't back away from those problems. We came up with bold, decisive actions that didn't just try to, you know, just continue and do what was popular necessarily. And I really appreciate and I cherish being part of a board and working with the superintendent to see that these are the tough problems that the district faces, and that we take decisive action to solve them. So for all those reasons, and also on a very personal level, I mean, I see I first got involved when Richard Boker, who was my old history teacher, called me up and asked me if I was interested in this. And he also represented that same value, that when they put District 15 and they have a true love for District 15 and they understand what it stands for. It stands for outstanding academics. It stands for diversity and inclusive education to everybody. And this district is great because there are all sorts of ethnicities, all sorts of socioeconomic background, and it truly is what makes me proud to be a member of this board and not any other school district. So thanks again for, personally, and I wish you all the best.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. And all in favor of adjourning?
Aye.
We are. Thank you.
We'll take about a 5-minute break to let board members exit. Ladies and gentlemen, we have the Honorable Judge Jill Moraci here to administer the oath of office to our newly appointed or elected board members.
All right, when you need these, congratulations, everyone. And good evening. The Board of Education is charged with the governance of free public education afforded to all children in this community. This charge comes with tremendous responsibility to all of you as to the quality of education provided our children, and that will greatly impact their future as well as the future of the community, state, and the nation. It is no small task you are accepting tonight. Taking the oath tonight will be your public declaration of fully accepting this position in charge. Please respond, "I do," after the following phrases. Do you solemnly swear that you will faithfully discharge the duties of the office of member of the Board of Education of Community Consolidated School District 15 in accordance with the Constitution of the United States, the Constitution of the State of Illinois, the laws of the State of Illinois, to the best of your ability?
I do.
Do you further swear that you will respect taxpayer interest by serving as a faithful protector of the school district's assets?
I do.
Do you swear that you encourage and respect the free expression of opinion by your fellow board members and others who seek a hearing before the board while respecting the privacy of students and the employees?
I do.
Do you recognize that the board member has no legal authority as an individual and that decisions can only be made by a majority vote at a public board meeting?
I do.
And finally, do you swear to abide by the majority decisions of the board while retaining the right to seek changes in the decision through ethical and constructive channels?
I do.
Okay, well, you're on with board members. Congratulations, best wishes.
All right, the first order of business is to appoint President Pro Tem to get the meeting going. Do I have a motion to appoint President Pro Tem?
I'll make the motion to appoint President Pro Tem of Lisa Shupai.
I'll make a motion to appoint
Scott
Johnson.
Second. So I have a second for my appointment. This is a temporary part
well,
of
that's
the,
fine.
The temporary. And so I'm only going to do this for a short time, thank goodness. All in agreement of me being President Pro Tem, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Thank you. We also would need to appoint a secretary pro tem until one is elected, and so I would suggest that Ms. Becker be our secretary pro tem until we have an official secretary. Have a motion for that, please?
Motion is second.
And a second?
Second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
And Ms. Becker, you're secretary pro tem. So we'll call this meeting to order, and Ms. Becker, will you have a roll call, please?
Anarino?
Here.
Porter?
Here.
Kane?
Here.
Khan?
Here.
Samoka?
Here.
Shupai?
Here.
Wang?
Here.
Wong, right?
Wong.
Okay, I am now entertaining motions to nominate the board president for the next year.
I make a motion to nominate Lisa Shupai for president of the board.
Okay, we have one nomination for president, Mrs. Shupai. Are there any other nominations or appoint any other nominations going once? Since there are no other nominations, congratulations, Ms. Shupai. You are the board president, and the meeting is yours.
Vice President, please.
I nominate Mike Smolka.
May I have a second?
Second.
Second.
Any other nominations? Congratulations, Vice President.
May I have a nomination to elect somebody for the position of Board of Education Secretary?
Make a motion to nominate Anthony Wong for the position of secretary.
Second?
Second.
Are there any other nominations?
Congratulations. You get to put your signature on a lot of things in the next year. So
perfect.
Motion to establish the time and place of regular Board of Education meetings, please.
I make a motion to approve the regular meetings of the Board of Education through June 30th, 2017 to be held at the times and places indicated on the 2016-17 schedule as revised, approved on July 20th, 2016, and the proposed 2017-18 schedule.
Second?
I second that.
Wonderful. Is there any discussion?
So, a vote.
Porter?
Aye.
Kane?
Aye.
Khan?
Aye.
Samoka?
Aye.
Shupai?
Aye.
Wong?
Aye.
Anarino?
Aye.
May I have a motion to adopt and enforce all rules, regulations, and policies of the preceding Board of Education? And to adopt and enforce all necessary rules for the management and governance of the schools of Community Consolidated School District 15, Palatine, Cook County, Illinois.
I make a motion to adopt and enforce all rules, regulations, and policies of the preceding Board of Education and to adopt and enforce all necessary rules for the management and governance of the schools of Community Consolidated School District 15, Palatine, Cook County, Illinois.
Second?
Second.
Any discussion? Kane?
Aye.
Khan?
Aye.
Samoka?
Aye.
Shupai?
Aye.
Wong?
Aye.
Anarino?
Aye.
Porter?
Aye.
If you didn't notice, Ms. Becker rotates the person that's called first, so she keeps you on your toes. So just so you know that.
Just trying to figure that out, I have to admit. Before we adjourn, is there an opportunity to make a statement?
You're the president.
Oh, sweet. What I want within reason, right? I'd just like to take a moment to thank our outgoing board for their service and dedication. We all know, having been involved for quite a long time, the amount of time and effort and energy that they've put in, and all of us are in the same position to do to that as we move forward. I am sure I speak for each new board member seated today in saying how excited we are
to begin our efforts to positively impact our community. Despite the somewhat unusual process of filling the seat vacated by Ms. Morrison, we are all very much looking forward to working together with the members of our new Board of Education. It is clear that the six of us that were just seated, inclusive of Mr. Border, are uniquely qualified in different areas, and we bring much to the table. We are also very fortunate to have Mr. Kahn's experience and perspective to help guide us forward as we work to develop a strong team with solid decision-making and good results for District 15. There's no doubt in my mind that this group will work together very well to overcome obstacles and positively impact our community. And I would like to say to the public and the community that we really appreciate you placing your trust in us. Thank you. May I have a motion to adjourn the meeting?
So moved to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn, yes.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Meeting adjourned.
Let's take a quick photo here with